Oh, never mind. The her boss, their boss, their boss. Sif's sign is actually in the boss chamber.
What?
Yep.
It's like in the chamber.
Yep.
Of secrets.
Have fun.
The abyss. I fought worse things. Oh, that hand. I forgot about that thing. That's the abyss. That. Wow. Oh, okay. Well, I'm a little shaky. Wow. This fucking weapon was not intended for cutscenes. Excuse me? Are you a dragon? Oh no, you're just like a demon. With a fucked up arm. Alright, dude, well, I've got teeth bigger than you on
this
my back.
This is like a Miyazaki villain.
Where is Sif's summoning sign? There it is. Ow! Wah. That is a hand.
There goes a lot of your health. Good luck.
I'm summoning this fucking thing. Don't you forget it!
Oh god. He's like on top of it now. There you go. Try to die.
Oh, I'm fat rolling.
Oh no.
I forgot about
that. Oh no. Oh no. You got your numbers wrong?
I fixed it.
Oh. Oh boy.
There we go.
Try not to be a dead. Good luck.
What the fuck?
And maybe watch for tells that might indicate it's time to use the anti-magic pendant.
Well, Sif's here.
I'm a tiny wolf.
Get him.
Are you getting flashbacks of Breath of the Wild right now?
Yeah, this thing's
with your constant wolf link summoning.
What the fuck is with this fucking monstrosity of a boss?
Have fun. Good luck.
Oh yeah? Fucking duel, bitch!
Nope, oh, I got you back.
Yeah, whatever.
A lot. Jesus. Still want a face tank?
Yes.
Infinite strategy. Well, the more that you aggro him, the less he gets to hit Sif, I guess. Oh god, you're very... Oh god.
Fuck.
You better heal fast.
Whoop. Ow, what? I can't even... This fucking weapon is so slow, I can't even dodge that.
I like how easily I can tell that you make contact with them, because you literally freeze frame mid-swing for a moment.
Oh, wow!
Just add weight to it. Yep, there it is.
Hey,
that's the big bad magic. Better be careful, or you're gonna be in the deads.
Hey, how?
You're half dead. Whoa. I think you stunned him. Flurry of blows. You better be careful. Oh, boy. You're on the edge. Woohoo! Gotta get them healths up. Oh, we're going after Sif now. Buddy Sif, no!
Cram!
God damn, you do a lot of health in one hit.
Yeah, I do. That's why this fucking
nail
is
great.
You just
gotta land him in the first place. Woo! Oh, that was actually... I think that was a proper roll. I'm not used to those.
Stop hitting my dog!
You should probably heal. You're less than half health. Fuck. Oh no.
Ow, that hurt.
Yes! It did, didn't it? Interesting that. Sif's half dead. Sif and his odd fur texture. His Sonic Unleashed fur texture.
Wow, that really took out my shield. How about
yeah,
no?
Yeah, pretty much just blocked that.
Yeah,
one more hit!
Done.
Oh, you beat Madness in your first try.
Yeah, because I have a giant fucking tooth.
And 100 million billion flasks and a summon. Hooray!
Oh, there's a person here.
Yeah, don't hit her.
I got 10 humanity from that? Shit. I got 60,000 souls from that? Shit. Okay, are you done talking? Okay, great. There we go.
All of the Lord Vessel bosses gave you 60,000.
Oh, did they? Wait,
yeah.
He's a Lord Vessel?
No, but he's the same tier of experience reward.
Well, goodbye to that lady, I guess.
You remember her, right?
Yeah, she's the one who...
Yeah, you saved her.
Yeah.
She was in the abyss, and now she's not.
Oh, yeah? Well, bam! Purge yourself!
You didn't save Artorias, though. Artorias fucked up.
I did save him. Put him out of his misery.
Well, we did it.
And his wolf got justice.
And he got 10 humanity. Wolf got justice until later, when the person that did that with the wolf then goes on to desecrate their grave.
Well, it's his fault for caring about a grave, for some reason. Also, I put him there. Maybe I can visit it. Let's see. So, is this it? Is the DLC over?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
You beat the DLC.
Oh. Okay.
Ready to beat the game, Andrew?
Yeah, I guess. Where do I go now?
You just go to Firelink.
Well, before I do that,
okay. we gotta go to Firelink and then get deep throated by a
worm monster. Oh right, I forgot. I have to put the souls in the dishwasher. Whatever that thing is, the soup bowl. All right, so I'm gonna rest here.
I like how one of the strategies for this boss is listed as effortless for every class. From the right side ledge in the cave just before the white boss portal that leads to Manus, if you look downwards in the darkness, you can see Manus's red eyes glaring back at you. Manus can be damaged before you enter the portal. The damage taken by him remains even after you enter the portal. In short, you can take Manus down effortlessly with a ranged weapon from this ledge.
What? I could have done that the whole time?
You could just... like as if you actually had struggle with that fight. You beat him on your first try.
Hey, wake up, dude.
That's also, which is funny.
How do you wake this guy?
It's funny to me that it works, Andrew, because if you go fight Sif and then leave, Sif will then be in his boss chamber waiting for you, as opposed to waiting for that cutscene to trigger.
Yeah.
And then you can just stand on a ledge and shoot him with arrows, because you can see him from one of the ledges. So that's funny that Sif and Manus, considering you can summon Sif for Manus, it's funny that those are both bosses that works on.
How do you wake this guy up?
Punch him? I wouldn't use a weapon. Oh god.
No, I'm fine.
Okay.
I'm fine. Well and wide awake.
Oh, he seems okay with it.
Treat me like
yeah, I guess
an old
so.
Withering snake.
What happened to your testicle? There it is. All right.
I am pleased. Is it something urgent?
Yeah, I need to go down. What do you get when you feed him shit? I think
it's the only way in the game to sell stuff.
What?
You can feed him stuff and then you'll get souls for it. If you feed him large shards, I believe it just downgrades them into smaller shards or something. But if you feed him items, like you just that's the only way to sell stuff for souls. Because you can't sell stuff in this game.
What are the shards for then?
I just told you.
Are they just smaller shards?
I think it breaks them down into smaller ones. I'm not entirely sure.
Oh, he like chomps on them with his giant nasty teeth.
Yeah, I've never used this feature.
Alright. Well, let's warp.
Well.
In other games you can just explicitly just sell stuff in many cases.
Are you gonna eat me with this giant tooth on my back?
Yeah. Oh no, it's just mysteriously vanished in this cutscene.
Okay, well I don't need to watch that. I've seen it a million times.
And it bothers you.
All right,
emotionally.
Oh, yeah, it does, actually. Alright. Rest at Lord Vessel. Sure. Offer souls to Lord Vessel. See, look at his little baby hand. It's all crunched up. Oh, my. So if I click offer souls, it just puts all of them in there at one time?
It might put all of them in. Oh, yeah, I think the door's about to open. Yep.
Oh, so it did just put all of them in there.
Yay, time saver. If only that happened for the fucking Chaos Servant Covenant. We have to offer them like 58 in a row.
Ew, gross.
It sucks.
Ah! It's like blazing. Shit's too hot. Turn it down. Oh my god, you're just ridiculous. I hate your existence.
The way is hanging from above?
Yeah.
Anime hallway!
Wait, I can't go down it. Oh, there we go.
Anime hallway! Look at this anime hallway!
Is it an anime hallway?
Oh my god!
Oh, there's spooky ghosts. Can I kill them?
Equivalent exchange!
Nope, I can't kill
Equivalent them. Exchange! Oh my god, you're going to the other side to London!
Oh.
Oh, this is alternate history London when the Blitz was really successful.
Yeah, that's a really successful Blitz. Shit.
I don't think we're gonna fight a dragon in this timeline.
Are these even trees anymore? I don't even... Like, where the fuck are we?
It's an unusual visual.
This is all like dust. Ew. It's like
it's fucking, ash.
It's all ash.
You are in the kiln of the first flame.
Am I in Ash Lake?
You're going after Gwyn.
Oh shit, who are you? Wait, what?
Sup? By the way, those enemies. Oh, that's awkward. Oh, that's awkward. Oh, I guess he blocked it.
Fuck.
I guess he blocked it the last second, because that was surprising. I was like, I wonder how flat he's going to be, and he was not. Wow, he can really tank that shit.
He can. Stop tanking shit. Tinite chunk. I don't need that. Could you... Excuse me, please give me something better. Alright. This looks like a really tedious long walk that I might have to take.
Yep.
Multiple times.
We'll try not.
We'll try not. I would be upset if I actually beat the boss on my first try. The final boss of the game, just, well.
I think the first time I ever played Dark Souls, I beat the final boss on my first try.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
That's impressive.
It's not like the boss of Demon's Souls that's like literally like a non-boss, but oftentimes the final bosses of Souls games are surprisingly easy. But this one does give you a proper fight. It's normal to have some trouble with them, but I didn't for some reason.
Why can't I roll when I am hit? Or like, why didn't it hit me out of the ground? Why did it do a side thing where I like... Okay.
Did you try blocking?
I couldn't move. I couldn't move at all. I couldn't roll. I couldn't block.
Did you try blocking?
Yes. I try blocking instantly. The moment I get hit, I always hold block. All right, let's fucking... Let's go back to tried and true. Don't. All right. Well, I still have 20 flasks.
But what if they poison you, Andrew?
I'm not worried about it.
Oh, yeah, the fucking Lord vessel already kindled. It's the Lord vessel.
Yeah, I also need to get my souls back because I forgot to use my souls.
You put all of the Lord's souls inside of it. It's the most kindled the thing can get.
Really? 20? That's pathetic. What do I do with these souls, by the way? I have so many souls.
You could have leveled up with them, like always.
Even the big ones?
Yeah.
Okay, let's duel.
You can either use them in transmutations to get high-level items. Like, if you, like, get a, I don't know, scimitar to plus 15 or whatever, then you can, like, convert it into, like, Jordan's scimitar or something. Like, as an example. That's not a thing that exists.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about, though. You can turn it into something.
When you upgrade a weapon enough, then you can evolve it into, like, a unique special boss weapon.
Yeah, I've seen it with the club and stuff like that.
So all of those souls can be used for those purposes, or you can just eat them.
I can just eat them and then get, like, the soul equivalent out
all
of that, them?
All of them are worth some number of souls, yeah.
Really?
Yep.
That was a weird strike, and I'll let you have it, but never again.
It's something that I absolutely never do, because I just kind of keep my future options open.
Future options?
Yeah. See, I never know when I'm going to go back and, like, record, like, a New Game Plus playthrough of some game or something, and at that point, like, I might decide to use Jordan's scimitar or whatever the fuck. And so then I'm like, oh, I've got the soul just sitting right here.
Oh, New Game Plus just keeps all your items, too?
Yeah, except for keys.
What? But why? Wait, I can carry the souls of enemies and then kill those enemies again to carry more of their souls,
but
I can't have multiple keys.
Well, no, it's because you have to they make you play the level.
Well, I know, but fuck you.
So you lose the keys that would open up all the doors and let you skip everything. Unless, of course, your gift is the master key.
Fuck. Oh, no. Okay, never mind. Okay, that door's open still.
But yeah, you can get multiple of everyone's souls. You can play the game infinite times.
Just have 40 of the fucking...
Yeah, someone's done it.
All right, well,
hard, though.
I mean, I'm sure it gets...
Because at some point, you start hitting all of those caps on how well your stats scale, but the enemies just keep getting tougher every time you go into New Game Plus again, and at some point, it just becomes, like, untenable. You can look up playthroughs of people just sprinting through the entire game, because at some point, beating the game on the highest like New Game Plus cycles basically just involves sprinting all the way to each boss.
Oh.
And you're like you're perfectly timing all of your dodges to dodge every single enemy that swings at you.
Wait,
because they'll one shot you.
This is it, right?
This is it.
This is it.
This is the end.
Okay.
So if you want to eat your shit, you can eat your shit.
I mean, all my souls. All
right. Enjoy the cringe, audience.
Well, all of these souls.
Oh,
not the Lord.
You're not going to eat any of the bosses in case you do a New Game Plus playthrough someday?
Yeah, I don't know. Probably I'll never do it, but...
Keeping your options open?
I guess.
Yeah. That's what I do. I'm always like, I don't want to use them up because you never know when I'll use it again. Although when I keep upgrading computers and all these other things, like I often like will not quite remember to keep all of my Dark Souls saves across all different Souls games, so that kind of fucks things up anyway. You have 8 of those? Jesus. Yeah, put those on your bar.
Yeah. Well, I was getting rid of the ones that I can just do in one shot.
There are later games where you can, like, click on one, and then, like, it'll say how many you want to use. You can hit down to use all of them.
Use to acquire souls.
Used to acquire souls.
Used to acquire souls.
Lord of the Soul, or Soul of Lords.
Lord of the Soul Dance. You dance.
So this is where you'd be able to summon Solaire if he was alive.
Oh, really? You could summon Solaire to join me on my journey through this place?
Yeah. Well, I think you summon him, like, right before the boss. But yeah, you can fight the boss with Solaire if he had not died horribly.
Holy shit.
But instead he died horribly.
That's fine. I don't need nobody to help me through this area.
You never saw Onion Knight ever again.
I think I know where he is. Someone commented and was like, yeah, we left Onion Knight here. And I was like, oh well.
I wonder if do you want to track him down? Or do you just like, eh?
I don't remember what that person said, and also I don't care. Like,
the last thing he said, it was that he was going, he was doing the dialogue that normally leads to him being in Blighttown, which I told you at the time.
Yeah.
But we never looked for him in Blighttown. I don't know if he stays in Blighttown or if he eventually teleports down, but you know that place where there was a, you fell into that really irritating poison pit chamber full of the blender monsters?
Yeah.
That was like, it took like you 20 minutes to get out of it. That's normally where he ends up.
Yeah, you're telling me that.
Yeah.
Wow, I can level up 4 times.
And then you get into a really confusing fight where, like, the number of, It's really confusing where, like, you can help him fight those monsters, and then I think based on where his health ends up or something like that, you need to get him to succeed at living through that fight, but not too well or something, or I don't know, it's confusing. Like, if his health is, like, above or below a certain threshold, he'll just kill himself. Because he's failed as a knight, and because you keep fixing all of his problems throughout the entire game, so he gives up on his quest.
Sounds complicated. I'm not very good at that kind of stuff.
Because you opened Sen's Fortress for him, and you diverted the boulders for him, and you saved him in Anorlando and stuff like that.
Well, I'm not a knight,
So if you keep saving him over and over again, he eventually just gives up and goes hollow. If you succeed at doing the exact perfect threshold that lets him continue forward, then you can find him and his daughter at Ash Lake together.
That's cute.
And it's basically like watching a daughter visit her dad at the senile home because he's losing his mind.
What?
And she's taking care of him as he loses his mind.
He's losing his mind?
Because now that his mission's over, he's just going to slowly go hollow there.
What?
It sucks to be in this universe. It doesn't work well for anyone.
Are you sure? It's working well for me.
Almost every character you've ever met is dead or insane or dead end. Insane then dead.
Well, I still have 13.
Some of them died so many times they went insane.
I still have 13,000 souls left, which nothing I can do. But I leveled up 4 times.
All the people back in town are still alive, though.
Huh?
All the people back in town are still alive. The pyromancer.
I don't know where that pyromancer went.
Oh, did he leave?
He's gone.
Oh.
Same with the other magic guy.
Too bad that you did weird dialogue with him without talking.
We talked. Someone told me in the comment section it was about like Quaylag's sister or something. He like asked about Quaylag's sister.
Oh. He probably went off to find the one pyromancer trainer that you met in the swamp.
Ah.
That lady. Who I was corrected a lot.
That was
about
not the
how
witch.
It's not the witch, it's the nether sister, because there's fucking 12 sisters.
You mean daughters?
Yeah. Well, they're all sisters of each other.
How does a tree give birth to a spider?
No. I don't think she was a tree.
What?
I don't think
a spider?
I don't think she was originally a tree.
But was she a spider?
I think she was a woman, and then she made chaos monsters with her with pyromancy.
Oh, I thought you meant
pyromancy is not a happy element of magic.
It's just like
it's chaotic, insane magic, and it makes messes.
It
made all of the lava zones essentially. Is like they were essentially like full of, like with the demons and the chaos monsters and the sisters, the daughters of chaos, and so on, and like all those characters are a result of that stuff, and it's a mess.
Sounds like a very, very fun time.
Right. She was one of several people that were trying to figure out how to
fix the world.
Kinda, yeah.
Yeah. Everyone's a hero in their own way.
Everyone's a hero in their own way.
Don't do it, dude.
What, him or
not
me?
This guy.
I was like, that was weirdly frank.
This is why I didn't want
you
to do that.
You Philly and me.
Goodbye.
Oh wow, that was perfect.
That's why I didn't want him to do it. I knew he was gonna fall off the ledge.
Because yeah, like the soul of not the soul of man, the flame of man was dying out, so Gwyn sort of sacrificed himself to maintain it
by becoming the soul itself.
So he's just been hanging out in the kiln in the first
Wait,
flame,
what?
Just burning. Oh, is that where his corpse landed?
Yeah.
He just died in midair? Well, you're not getting that.
I guess I'm not. Thanks for not putting it on the ledge.
Probably not very important. The,
twin humanity. So,
Gwyn has literally been just burning himself, by the way.
I mean, yeah,
he's
what
just,
else do you do?
He's just kind of standing
in
fire. He's
just in the fire, right?
Whereas the Witch of Izalith is like, I'm gonna use I think she's trying to make another flame of man or something, and I don't think it worked.
Everyone seems a little misguided.
Yeah.
Clearly, you just need
Seath
to kill
Seath really
people.
Has any save humanity motivations. I think he's just a lunatic. He betrayed the dragons because they were dicks, and then, just kind of went crazy in his own little private dukedom cave, being a shitty, legless, blind dragon with no scales.
He went crazy in his own private.
He's a dragon who's blind, legless, and has no scales.
What? Black Knight Great Axe?
And he has to be artificially... He has to make himself artificially immortal with that thing you broke.
I mean, artificially immortal is still immortal.
Yeah.
Still
until,
sounds pretty...
Until it wasn't.
Well, yeah, but I don't think he expected someone to come ham-fisting in there and breaking
everything.
You think
he'd protect it
more? Huh?
You think he'd protect it more? I guess the entire crystal cave was kind of protecting it, but you think he'd
like,
put like a box around it?
I mean, I don't think anybody was ready for me to
or
show
like,
up.
You think he'd bury it? Like, just really hide
it.
Put in a time capsule, dig like 50 feet of ground up, and then just bury it.
He could also just put crystal around it.
Maybe he had to touch it every now and then.
I can't break the crystal.
Maybe he had to touch it every now and then to, like, be immortal.
He
had to recharge his cell phone battery that it was his immortality.
I guess this is it, right?
Yeah.
All right.
So when you beat this boss, stand still. After you beat him, stand still. Don't walk afterwards. I'll talk to you about it then.
Does he have, like...
Yeah, he's got
shit!
A flame sword.
That's a huge fucking flame sword, dude!
Yeah, it is. Get ready to get Gwyn, motherfucker. I see you've given up on the tooth.
I didn't give up on the tooth. I forgot to equip it before I went in here because I'm a
it's
bad
okay.
player.
It's okay. Just specifically farmed for it for the amount of time that I don't know. Also, he does fire damage, obviously, so you're not going to get 100% block.
Would you stop?
Don't get grabbed by him. In case you somehow didn't understand that detail of how you don't want to get grabbed by him. What he's doing is really...
I'm imagining he's doing something
really
I don't want to
slow telegraphed grabs. I'm like, I don't know if you want to do that. It might be a bad idea.
Could you not?
The grab looks really funny when he's nowhere near you. Like... You are below half. Oh, now you're below half.
Oh, nope. Okay, stop with that. Jesus. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when I come for you? All right. Could you? It's just like the.
You don't like how he keeps dancing?
He's just kind of boring, honestly.
Yeah, he's just a swordsman and not even a particularly dramatic one. Uh-oh.
Great.
Explosions.
What the.
He cast combustion on you. He's gonna stab you.
Oh.
Backswing. You better heal. You better heal good. Oh shit.
Good thing
you have 20 flasks.
Yeah, good thing. Not like I planned for that.
Are you missing your tooth right now?
Kinda, yeah. Oh, he went the fucking.
He kept going. He's got long range charges.
He has like a fucking ridiculous jump, by the way.
Yep.
And you can't backstab this guy.
We've reached the peak we've reached the tipping point where Dark Souls goes full anime with its boss fights, and they start like floating through the air and dashing at you, and I'm gonna grab you and then explode you with my hand, and stuff like that. You probably would have more luck with a lot of these attacks if you tried rolling forward through them instead of slowly walking backwards.
What?
If you kind of roll forward, then you kind of end up ending up behind.
Well,
him
I did roll forward,
around.
And then he like does a 360 spin, and I didn't really know how to deal with that.
So if a guy's doing a continuous combo in a straight line, then pacing backwards does not help ever. Well, he's getting low.
Yep. No, thank you. I do not need hugs.
No hugs, please. No explodey hugs. Hug explosions.
See, just.
This isn't nice having a billion flasks.
Yeah, it is nice, but like. I kind of wish. Like, the fucking boss I fought before this guy was actually a threat.
Oh, yeah. Manus is. I think Manus is seen as one of the harder bosses in the game at this point. but you tanked him up.
I'm just beating up an old man at this point.
There was a tipping point in this playthrough where you noped your way away from the ONS fight, and you're like, I'm going to outstats this game.
I guess I did.
And then you did.
I guess I did. All right, Grandpa, if you're going to two-hand, I'll two-hand too.
Because during the ONS fight, you're like, nope, I'm going to come back when I'm too powerful. All right, so now you have a choice. You can save humanity. You can continue what Gwyn did and burn yourself in order to continue the duration of mankind and the flame of man. Or you can walk out the door you came through and doom it to darkness.
Just doom
that's
it?
That's your choice, is you can either become the next person to burn, because Gwyn was losing his strength and had to be defeated and replaced. Or you could just be like, nah, I just kicked it over to kick it over, and I'm leaving now. That's a choice.
Is there, like, what happens if I do that?
You get an ending cutscene in both cases. It's over now. So which ending do you want?
I don't know. Well,
and they're both right and wrong at the same time, because like, this act of continually doing this, it's like, it's prolonging the inevitable. It's an inherently temporary fix.
Yeah.
But do you fight for the hope, or do you abandon and decide that it's time for whatever comes next?
I mean,
they're both good and bad endings at the same time in many ways.
I'll just be honest, I just don't want to live anymore. This fucking place sucks. Like, why do I even want to go outside?
Well, there it goes.
Like, I would rather just light the fire and stay in this nice,
comfy
room.
Come on, baby, light my fire.
Like, it just seems more reasonable to stay in this room and not deal with the shittiness that's outside.
That's a cool mask for lighting yourself on fire.
It is, actually.
You look like a...
I look like a furnace.
Yeah.
I should have just full Havel geared up.
You could have.
I would have been smarter.
Now you can't. You have to play the whole game again in order to do that cutscene differently.
Perfect. And that's it, huh?
Yeah, you did it, Andrew. You actually beat Dark Souls.
What a shock.
You beat your first Souls game out of 5.
Fuck.
You didn't like how that sentence ended?
No, that's a bad sentence.
Now all that's left is Dark Souls 2 and Dark Souls 3 and Bloodborne and Demon's Souls. And then we can go into the Souls-likes, so you can play Neo and Lords of the Fallen.
I ain't doing Souls-likes. Fuck that shit.
I do want to play Salt and Sanctuary with you.
People have told me to play Salt and Sanctuary, but I'm not doing fucking Neo.
Yeah.
That game looks like
I think you'd like Salt and Sanctuary, because it's a 2D side-scroller Souls-like, and it has co-op.
As local.
Yeah, that's why I suggested it, as local co-op.
God.
I beat it twice already. I beat it as a melee character and as a spellcaster character, but co-op. Shared screen local co-op in a Castlevania-style game with Souls combat? Like, that'd be fun.
I just realized, by the way, it took me I was sitting there and I was farming for the Drake, or for the Dragon Scales.
Yeah.
And I realized, you know what that Dragon Tooth is?
What?
It's just the fucking Iron Reaver, or it's the fucking sword from Inuyasha.
Oh, his giant, weird, curvy,
sword. That curve thing is just his dad's tooth.
Oh, is it?
It's just his dad's tooth that he took, and his dad was just, like, giant fucking
I always forget how dumb Inuyasha is.
Yeah, but, like, I was holding Inuyasha's weapon, basically, which is, like, I could just spam Iron Reaver Soul Stealer all day, just in the ground, like...
Man, I hate that entire story.
I mean,
just all of it.
You act like there was a story.
I hate it so much.
It was just like,
it really is proto Twilight, which showed that like all the girls that I knew that were into Inuyasha also were into Twilight when it came out. And it's like, because it's almost the same
thing. It is the same thing.
All the way down to like, I'm torn between my vampire friend and my dog friend. Except vampire is a cat demon, I guess, but also has fangs. Everything's dumb. I was not expecting the credits of this playthrough to be dominated by Inuyasha talk.
Oh, you wanted to talk about the game? I mean, I just wanted to be... I wanted to talk about something that wasn't going to be, like, sour, bitter negativeness. I just wanted to, like, be fun.
And you beat Dark Souls, everybody celebrate!
It's all over now,
you begrudgingly
forever.
Beat Dark Souls.
I did, and the only way that I'll ever play it again is if someone pays me money to do it.
Until we play
sure.
the other games in this
series.
Well, I
mean, this one again.
Yeah.
I'll never play Dark Souls 1 again. It won't happen. No thanks. I'm keen off that shit.
Maybe if we can get a fixed PS3, we can play Demon's Souls. That was so weird watching your console just melt before us.
A lot of things melt before me, you just aren't here to see it.
I mean, you smoke a lot, so, like, it's like a part of your life.
Well, I mean, I'm saying...
I melt this outside of me to melt my inside of me.
Yeah, I guess it does happen. I guess it does happen. My life is a fucking mess.
How many bosses...
I killed every boss.
Did any boss in Artorias' DLC take 2 tries?
No. That took no time. I think the only effort...
No, you took 2 tries on Artorias himself, because you had to go get your souls, didn't you?
Yeah, because I fucked up.
I think you took 2 tries on the first boss?
Yes.
And also the second version of the first boss?
Well, I guess, yeah.
Okay, so you took 2 tries on 3 of the bosses out of 5.
But, like, Artorias I fucked up because I didn't roll again before doing the thing, before healing. The first boss was just me fucking destroyed by it. I had no... Like, Artorias was almost dead. I was, like, 2 or 3 strikes from killing it. The first boss, I was nowhere near killing.
You were like, I don't understand what to do.
That first boss just wrecked me, which was harder than somehow
riggedy,
the dragon.
Riggedy.
Like, the dragon took no effort. And neither did fucking the final boss, because it's just the wolf just kept hitting it. And I was like, oh, free shot. 600 damage. 600 damage. I wish I did it with fucking Gwyn. Now I'm disappointed, because I want to see how quickly I could have just beat an old man on fire.
Yeah, I was surprised just how valid tank mode was for the second half of the game, more or less.
It's useful.
I think it becomes less valid in sequels, but we'll see.
I'll find a way, Keith. I'll find a way
Prepare
to make it
to
always.
Prepare to die edition 2012.
I died, I guess. Oh,
The video game release that led to Vati Vidya's entire YouTube channel. Because he didn't play Dark Souls till the PC version came out. The dark sign brand. It's just starting over.
Wait, what? It's starting over?
Yep.
Wait, it's just...
Yep.
Oh.
Yep.
Oh.
Hey, look, it's the key.
I have this weapon?
Yep.
Wait, I thought I was lighting the fire. Did it just throw me back?
So, no, you don't canonically loop the entire timeline of the game. But the way that it handles New Game Plus is you just start the game again.
Well, those guys are still as easy as ever.
Are you just going to start playing again?
No, it's just
what
like...
What are you doing? No one paid you.
Hold on. I want to fight this first boss.
Just to see how fast he dies?
Yeah, see how fast he dies. But I'm not
sure.
Fucking this shit.
You don't even have to, you don't even have to do the whole, like, loop around. Because you don't have a broken sword.
Yeah. I can just straight beat him.
Surprise, motherfucker.
Yeah, I can just straight beat him, actually. I mean, I guess you could straight beat him in the broken sword, but only if you're a lunatic.
New Game Plus, everyone has a percent higher of health and damage and whatnot, but yeah, you are very much probably going to outclass this dude.
I fought you 3 times. Let's do it.
Let's make it number 4.
Where the fuck did he go? Oh, there he is.
What's up, brah?
Holy shit!
Can you 3-shot him, or is there going to be more than that? You should be 2-handing it.
Oh, I should be 2-handing it.
Disgrace.
Caught him in midair. Dead. Oh, I got the Demon's Great Hammer.
Yep, that's the reward for killing him without doing the loop around. Which is way easier to do the second time around. It's locked. Now I think you have to go around and get the key. Because you have to meet Oscar canonically.
The inherent threat is gone. Oh, what a great game.
See you guys next time.
Goodbye. I'm sorry that I suck.
Final note?
Yeah, that's my last will and testament.
I apologize for me.
I apologize for everything involved. Quit.
Time to close all these Dark Souls
tabs
in my browser.
I haven't been this sure of something in my entire life.